So what is the difference between software architecture and software design? Well, this is a simple question or looks simple with lots of answers and lots of subjective answers. And the weird thing is that not all answers are incorrect. All subjective answers are correct in one way or other. But when it comes to articulating the same thing as well as understanding this particular thing, we find it very difficult to exactly differentiate between software architecture and software design. So in this particular video, I'm going to talk about the exact difference between software architecture and software design and what you should keep in mind while working on architecture as well as design. Now, before I go ahead, let me talk about one real world example. You can see a house behind me. In one house, I'm standing and there is another house next to me. Both these houses are exactly similar when it was delivered to their customers. But when you go inside these houses will be different based on the taste of the person, choice of the person. And similarly, if you go to a township where all houses are same from outside, they are different from inside. And their difference totally depends upon the person living in those houses. Of course, when the houses are created, it was created by considering a broad, you know, understanding in mind, broad choices in mind. But even then, when you go inside, all of those houses will be different. And this is the key to understanding software architecture and software design. So when the houses are delivered within a township, it is an architecture. But when it is different from inside, it is a design. And if you can consider the people living within those houses as programming languages, programming tools or databases, you can understand the impact and influence of software design. Just like the houses of a township, software architecture appeals to broad set of people, which means broad set of programming languages, programming tools and databases, which means a software architecture can be implemented using multiple programming languages, multiple tools, as well as multiple databases. So it is not aligned with one particular programming language, tools or database. Very similar to houses in a township is not aligned to one particular person. It appeals to a broader set of people. Similarly, software architecture appeals to a broader set of languages, tools and databases. Now, when it comes to software design, it is very, very similar to the people inside those houses. You got an architecture, but the inside will be totally dependent upon the kind of person living in there, their choices, their, you know, taste, or how many people are gonna live in that particular house. And the liking of one person may not be the liking of another person, which means that a software design is limited in nature, which effectively means that it is closely related to the features or constraints provided by the programming languages, programming tools and databases. For example, if we talk about object-oriented programming, those design patterns can only be used by object-oriented programming languages, other object-oriented programming languages. It can't be used by, you know, languages like C or Go. That's where the differentiation comes into picture. Software design is very much closely aligned with or closely coupled with programming languages you are using, programming tools you are using, you know, databases you are using. While software architecture is not aligned to, it may be influenced by a set of programming languages, tools and databases. It may be influenced by, but it is not closely aligned to a particular programming language, tools or database. So this is the difference between software architecture and design. I do hope and believe that I have explained the same in the clearest possible way, and you are going to remember the same for a long time. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will definitely meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.